And since the very beginning, the festival was strongly connected to the local community. Actually, it was founded by a mayor who decided, who thought at some point that citizens could learn something from theater and theater groups. The festival then developed and changed a lot during the last 45 years, also changing artistic direction regularly. But in its identity, what we can still recognize is a very strong connection between contemporary performing arts and the local context, and an international dimension that's developed further in the last years. Yeah, we can see festivals as temporary autonomous zones in certain respects, and I think this concept is quite complex actually, and also needs to be challenged. I mean, on one end, for sure, festivals are or can be autonomous zones and moments in time and in space where a temporary community is built. This is particularly important for us in Sant'Arcangelo. By working in a very local context, the festival is the moment when people also gather from all around Italy and from abroad, and the moment where you can feel and sense that the true community behind the festival is actually an extremely complex community of local citizens, artists, theorists, students, and so on. So in that respect, there is a kind of autonomy in the idea of festival, I do think so, and that's done, that's made also, that exists also because of the limited time where a festival exists. But for sure, I think that this temporality of a festival and this autonomy also needs to be challenged, meaning that the risk is exactly that festivals become exceptions. So places and contexts where anything can happen, so for example, where we can produce and display very risky contemporary performing arts productions, but contexts that cannot affect what exists around them. I mean the reality of the art system, for example, but also the reality of the everyday life of a small town like Sant'Arcangelo, and the reality of life of artists, and so on. Anyway, I think this is a big potentiality that festivals have. So they are a zone of a big intensity, where you have a big intensity in space and time in a festival like Sant'Arcangelo, for example. The question is, how can this intensity affect other times, and how can this border in between what the festival is and what is not the festival, so the before and the after, how this surface, this border can be stretched and can become actually a productive place, a productive gap perhaps also. But how this diversity, or this difference rather, this difference that we can experience between a festival and what is not a festival, the festival and the time after, for example, how this gap can be productive of change, I would say, for the artists and for the local communities and for the art organizations that produce festivals as well. We see the festival very much as a place of experience and knowledge production and sharing, I would say, and not at all as a showcase or as a program of performances. That's why in the last years we also developed projects that are not strictly theatrical, but that are aimed at approaching theater and the performing arts as a subject of research. Meaning as thinking entities that can trigger some reflections around certain topics, and that also have a very specific mode of researching, which is the mode, let's say, of art. So last year we started, in 2014, we started curating a school program that we actually co-curated together with Guy Gutmann, the director of the School of Visual Theatre in Jerusalem. The title was Nomadic School, The Host and the Cloud. Actually, the Host and the Cloud is the title of an artwork by Pierre Huyghe, a French visual artist. And we were fascinated by this concept of hosting, what does a festival host in the end, and the concept of the cloud as well, as an entity of pure potentiality, let's say. So the school was a kind of self-provocation also, or a way to raise a question about the festival and the very special place that is created when education and art meet. So when a school program happens in an art festival, how this affects both the school, the idea of education, and the festival. After that experience, that was extremely rich and that gathered 19 students from all around Europe, from Jerusalem, of course, as well, we decided to develop the idea of the school, and we are now planning a new school for 2015 that will be called the School of Exceptions and is curated together with Aleppo and with the University of Gießen. Aleppo is a small research platform founded by a philosopher and former artist, Daniel Blanda Gubai, in Brussels, and gathering other researchers and artists around some questions of research. Together with Aleppo, we thought for Sant'Arcangelo about a school of exceptions in order to investigate the concept of exception and state of exception. In relation also to this year's festival, that will be focused very much around the concept of art as a scandal and the question of what is an art allowed to do, what does art do, and what is it allowed to do. What we are interested in by curating the school is actually creating a possible border and a surface of contact and relation between two different bodies, let's say the school and the festival, but also the festival and the city, and questioning the temporality of the festival and the very idea that a festival or an art project is a space of total freedom where anything can happen just because it's an exception to the norm or to the normal time. So we are really trying to question, investigate, but also to stretch this border where these two surfaces of art and reality, let's say, or school and the city, for example, where they coexist or cohabit. The school will gather 12 international students via an open call. We are looking for students from all disciplines and particularly interested in people coming from philosophy for sure, but also from law, for example. So people who can tackle the question of exception from different points of view. Another important notion for the school is the notion of what we call porosity, meaning that the school is invited as a guest of the festival, but at the same time will become a host. I mean, the school will host the public debates and the talks with the artists in the public space, in the piazza. So it's a small group of people who will also invite other people, artists, professionals, theorists, but also audience members, to share some questions and to share them in the public space. We decided to organize, to curate a school within the festival as we feel more and more that the festival is a complex entity, and we were interested in inviting a group of people who will be busy with their own trajectory of research, but who will also get in touch with the burning matter of art and that the festival offers or displays. And that hopefully will also provide other understandings or other angles to look at this same art. The school will also be asked to edit a publication at the end. The publication will appear later on, probably during the autumn, also in order to stretch the time even more, and will be the final publication of a series of four publications that go under the title of How to Build a Manifesto for the Future of a Festival. So it's a way for us to question the notion of the future and also to question how an art institution can change, how do we approach change. And the idea was basically to create a shared and open manifesto that could develop during the months before and after this edition of the festival. We are, a group of people working in the festival, we are editing the first publications, The first one is dedicated to time, to the concept of time, how to build time. And the last one will be really given to the school as an open question about how to build the future. So the gesture is, of course, the gesture of giving to someone else the voice and the platform in order to collect text and images and develop thinking around the future of a festival. That's why we thought that the students, as complete strangers that will just gather with us for the days of the festival, could also then give us back something in that form, and also have a gaze at the possible notion of future, and hopefully also unlight aspects that we would never tackle ourselves.